You guys wearing your headphones? Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to Let's Play Drizzlepath Class. This is the third out of four games, at least so far, with the Drizzlepath name. Hopefully this one will be more interesting than the last one. And it's definitely from what I'm seeing, a lot shorter, anyway. Anyway, just going over settings. I turned the head bob off. That was annoying as hell. I'm playing this blind, but I did walk around a little bit in that starting house, and we had to clean windows and then straighten up pictures, and I didn't finish the picture, so just getting enough to feel for the controls and mess with it. I turned the mouse sensitivity way down. This always seems to be high with these. And the volume for everything way down. Interesting is that the master volume doesn't seem to control the music volume. Right, the master should be the volume of everything put together, and I don't know what the master controls because it didn't make the music get any lower. Display, V-Sync enable, ooh, unlimited. I wanted 60. Yeah. And graphics, yeah, I had to put it down a little bit. There was a little bit of stuttering when walking around. Shadows and anti-aliasing, put down a high. It's still a little bit of stuttering, so I turned on post-processing. So those are my settings. Chapter 1, Home, beginning. This game saves as you progress through chapters. Captain Kirk.
I should stop drinking and get the red rose from the abandoned house in the village. I want to commemorate my husband next to his grave, but first I need to tidy my home up a little. Let's start from the dirty windows.
So we're supposed to be getting a rose from an abandoned house. We have a cat. Okay. Is that the genie from the first? Not the first, the second game. What are other controls here? Interact is E. Okay, so there's no strafe, apparently. Interesting that you can use a controller with this. Road to home. So we have a bathroom, but there's no windows here, and apparently we're vampires, we're not reflected in the mirror. So you don't clean this thing.
There's nothing I can do about the broken glass.
You need a new window. So you have this cat that follows us all around. I mean, that's really dogs that do that? And apparently we have a stalker out here. Or do we?
Nice. Now fix the alignment of pictures.
The alignment of pictures. Okay, so from here on out, proceeding blind, I did not align any other pictures. Who changed the alignment, I wonder? I'm gonna hear some stuff. Small appliances and such. Exit. What other pictures need to be aligned? Is there something in here? Ah, yes. Because everyone loves coffee. Not everybody.
Okay, then. Before I leave, I need to look around if I miss something. After all, I am going on an adventure. Who knows?
This? No, I don't want my bag. Do I want to bring the cat? No.
There's nothing I can do about the broken glass.
That's a table, not broken glass. Don't want to bring the guitar? Can I open anything? Meow. The cat's cute. Don't I bring a book? A genie? From a previous game? A cat? Do I need shoes? It's still a little stuttering. I might have to put this down even more. We'll see what happens when we go outside. Do I need to bring some cookies with me? There's a guy out there? Stalker guy? I give up. What do we bring with us? Money?
Of course, my pills. Now, let's put on the boots and get going.
We're bringing our pills with us. What kind of pills are these? Are these for our mental health? I clicked on the sneakers. Okay, whatever. Unless we have mental health or we have a heart condition? What is it? What up, G? Can't see. Right.
God, my house looks small from the outside.
Hmm. Oh, we move quickly now. Chapter 2, Outdoor. There's a jump. The house is small from the outside. The question is it bigger on the inside? I'm leaving my kitties behind. Interesting rocks.
How I wish I could run, but impossible for me with the high heels.
Well, I wanted to pick the sneakers. We seem to be going faster now, though. Happened with the high heels. What's that? Oh, nothing. It was just a flower. I thought it was some kind of creature sitting there. Oh, We can barely jump at all. Oh, I just slow down.
Can chickens swim? I asked him in a drizzly dawn. Of course, he replied. They can run into water and stay there as much as they want to. How come? I wondered. He laughed and told me that it depends how realistic the developer scripts the AI for the chicken.
Okay.
Years later, I played a game called Drizzlepath and finally got what he meant by that.
Okay. Breaking the fourth wall. I keep trying to strafe and... That goes that way. Is there anything around this way? No. Alright, you're getting a little crazy with the bongos there. Step away from the bongos. Slowly, carefully step away. You're not stepping away. No, you're getting even more crazy now. Is that the abandoned house? A strange sound in the background for this piece. Alright, we have quite a few houses, looks like. Strange sounds around here, they're creeping me out. For all I know, it's just part of the music, I don't even know. There's a guy there. Creepy! Okay. Here I go again. From the chewed up mint stains all the way to the fresh smell of frozen daisies. I don't remember picking up this up. No matter how it becomes the winter of a birth, summer awaits to burn your solitude. Sooner or later, a butterfly rises up to heaven and calls your name to strictly forbid every spoiled ray of the moonlight. Okay. There is no tomorrow if a stag enslaves the newborn turtles in front of a broken mirror that we call life. If you say so. What's with the creepy guy? Is that her ex? So if I just go around this area, there's a note. I don't know where it is, it's just... Oh, I guess it's that note. Oh. We just have to be in the vicinity of it to look at it. The guy was creepy. Mm. So I'm guessing one of these houses we can go in and we want to get a rose from it. Isn't here. Maybe this is just something on the way. Did I look at all these? I did. So it's not here? The abandoned house? Did I look at this one? Yeah. Unless that's identical. I'm gonna hope that one of those houses is not the one we're supposed to go in, because I could not get in. Nothing back here. So where's the drizzle path? There's no path. I can't climb this. I figure I could get a good view of... Well, I can't even walk that way. Alright, never mind. Oh. Darkness?
Me and my sister Lara visited him at the morgue. He was just lying without fear of the past.
Well, now he's dead.
Suddenly, all our memories came to life when I was close to him again. But it was different. He wasn't trying to make me smile like he always did.
How can he?
Maybe he was watching me, trying to tell me something about our last day together. Maybe he was angry about the mistakes I did. I saw him struggling the consequences of ignorance, and I came close to him and whispered, "It is over."
Why would you whisper "it is over" to a corpse? I mean, no kidding, it's over. He's dead. Besides, wouldn't it be more correct to say the mistakes you made rather than the mistakes you did? The mistakes I did. Oh. First off, what was that? And second, is a crow? Am I supposed to go down there? Can I go down there? No. Yeah, what is that? That's not a random sound that's supposed to just happen in the middle of a countryside. It sounds like aliens invading or something. I can't go down there. I go back the way I came. Or are we somewhere else now? Well, the house is still over here? I heard that. Yeah, I don't see the houses here. Would be seeing them by now, wouldn't I? Oh, they're here. Just farther away than I remembered. What the hell are you? Wait. Was that a letter? Just a leaf. Birdies. I'm just checking these again in case maybe now I can go in them. Oh, so you're saying at the beginning that we're supposed to get a rose from an abandoned house. You say that those buttons being turned. Right, where now? Let's look over here, otherwise we're going back, I guess. We did not get a rose. Can't climb this. Maybe we can go further this way. Oh. Where's the drizzle path? I'm seeing no path. I am pathless. Can I climb the hill? No.
Used to be seaplanes flying around our town. We often enjoyed watching them near the ocean. Eric mentioned that some of them were float planes. I laughed and said they are both the same things.
Float planes?
Nope, he disallowed. There is a difference. Float planes have pontoons to take off or land on. Their body isn't intended to touch the water. He loved to make me feel ignorant. But I always sorted out by not talking to him for the rest of the day.
And
again, he knew how to make me generous one way or another.
He did he? Do tell. Do tell. Well, I like this music, actually. I found all of it rather pleasing so far, but this especially. It's quite a long walk to this abandoned house. Are we going back? Because that looks very familiar to the other bridge. Or very similar, anyway. Maybe we need to be crossing that bridge. We need to go up and over.
Oh, my head! I need to take a pill.
Okay. How do I do that? Alright. What's wrong with her head? Oh, I'm trying to strafe. Yeah, I don't know how to get from there up there. Did it just randomly happen? She has to take a pill for some reason? It's migraines, apparently? Well, there's no path and it's not drizzling, so I cry foul. I cry waterfowl. Oof. Oh, hello. Are you a foxy woxy? Foxy. Ah, what's the fox say? That's what the fox says? We found out what the fox says. What the fox say? Will you make that sound too? Aw. Well, there's two of them. The place is practically overrun here. Oh, let's get a look at him. Aw. They're adorable. Well, whatever you're looking for, I hope you find it. I'm gonna be on my way looking for an abandoned house with a rose in it. Because why not? Was that another fox? Something moved.
Foxes are major predators of hens, but when it comes to humans, they sometimes act as simple pets. If Eric were here now, he would act the guardian angel in such an unnecessary way. Sometimes he treated me like his little girl, with no teeth on her mouth. Getting help from him learning to drive was great pain because of his obsessions about trying to keep me secure. Now that he's not around, I miss everything about him. Even the least pleasing sides of his character make me sensitive.
No teeth on her mouth? Well, it seems like the dialogue was written by somebody with... Sorry. It seems like the dialogue was written by somebody who doesn't have a great understanding of English, but then yet read by someone with an English accent. Oh my god. You are creepy as hell. Another letter. I chase a poor man's last wish, and it is more than just a tragedy to the ones who sing the tale of his. Yes, there are exceptions for those words, as they imply a bitter truth in such a kind way. There is no misery for those who sing on the path of Drizzle. If you really want to hear the heavily accented narration of the Spanish lady, all you have to do is find the hidden text that float on the path of Genie. Alright, so you're referring to the Genie from the previous game, Drizzlepath Genie. So, no mystery for those who sing on the path of Drizzle. heavenly intonation of the Spanish lady. Who is the Spanish lady? This is like a British lady speaking. Oh, we're going down in there, are we? Okay. I was gonna say, let's look around up here a little bit more. That goes somewhere. Let's just go down. Is this gonna be weird? I thought I saw the man standing again. I mean, I realize it's probably her husband, but he creeps me out the way he just stands there, looking.
In order to open the sacred passage, I must fill this urn with blood.
Oh.
Should be able to find 3 amphoras filled with blood in this cave.
Okay, so I don't need to be draining my own blood. I can find blood. Am I dropping down? I guess so.